our channel LP Talks. This is your Lakshmipathy. For the last 3 days, due to some health issue, I'm not able to make any videos. I didn't intimate that. Sorry for that. Now I'm okay. So I just started posting videos. Today's topic is it is related to some tricky questions in electrical engineering. These questions are mostly important for any electrical graduate. These are some basic questions, but it will estimate the depth of the concept. Say if you are explaining these questions to anybody, they can assess you how much knowledgeable you are based on your way of understanding the things. So these questions I collected from one of my friend who I interviewed last time. So I'm just explaining those questions, not answers, only questions. I'm reading it. In future, in any one of the discussion or interview, if possible, in some of the videos based on your requirements, I may post answers to those questions. So keep watching, stay connected. Yeah, these are the tricky questions in electrical engineering, which may firstly look silly, but they are really make enthusiastic learners to analyze in different possible ways and understand the concepts in a most analytic and physical way. This ultimately creates a lot of love towards subjects and enhance the passion and physical way of understanding things. There is a most important rule for answering or analyzing these questions, that is not to apply any mathematics or general statements of inventors like Faraday's laws, Lenz's law, etc., or any formulas or expressions. Because example, math is one of the powerful tool to simplify and further analyze the electrical science, but mostly friends are getting carried away with these things and losing the physics that is happening inside every concept. For example, V equal to IR means people, 99% of people will simply use and proceed. They don't want to think what is V, what is I, what is R, what it really means. Nobody takes case about it. I don't bother about who don't care. But the people who are very much interested to learn about electrical things, I'm just trying to give some trigger point to them so that they can spend some time on these things. Here are a few questions. Why EMF is getting induced once the conductor cuts the magnetic field? What is happening inside the conductor? Why the induced EMF opposes the changes in very cause producing it? Because this similar principle is used in modern magnetic trains propulsion. Yes, whatever we have magnetic trains in today's world, we are using this concept. Why an inductor opposes alternating excitation and acts as a shot for a steady state excitation? What is happening inside it? No math or frequency expression. Simple way you can explain it, you can understand it. Why capacitor blocks DC and allows alternating quantities? Can current pass between the plates of capacitor? Why the current in the capacitor is called a displacing current? Why this generalized statement is used, like inductor absorbs reactive power and capacitor delivers reactive power? Can it be vice versa? So why can their roles be interchanged in the real power systems? Like capacitor as a parenting device, inductor as a voltage booster. Why MOSFET is faster than BJT? Why the current is flowing reverse for some duration during the reverse bias of diode? Why only enhancement mode MOSFET are used in real power electronic applications? Why secondary breakdown is absent in MOS? Why is MOS a PTC and BJT an NTC? Why the AC inductive drop of DC generator is not considered in the output terminal voltage equations? Mostly we will take care of here we have some commutator and all, but many people won't take care of it. And why a commutator is used for AC series motor? Why in a three-phase induction motor, when the rotor is excited, it rotates opposite to the direction of stator rotating magnetic field, not just Lenz law? And why can't the three-phase transformer rotate the same three-phase induction motor, as both are same with respect to working principle? Yes, anyhow it won't rotate, but how much you understand, you just think of it. In a line to ground fault with a neutral isolated situation, the fault current proven to be zero, then why can't we adopt such a system by which we can avoid the normal death due to leakage shocks and bring the advantage of grounded neutral by some other alternate ways? What is the difference between grounding and earthing? Ideal characteristics of an op-amp, it is stated that the gain is infinity, potential difference between the both inputs is zero. Then how we can justify the math Vout equal to gain into V difference? Why positive feedback op-amp characteristic is used for a Schmitt trigger or multivibrator circuits? Why actually BH curve non-linear? Why the frequency of noise is twice the supply frequency? Why it increases with magnetic flux density? Why does transformer hum, not just the magnetostriction? Whether transformer size is dependent on frequency? If so, why physically? Why the voltage regulation in a transformer is calculated with respect to no load voltage, while the machine it is with respect to full load voltage? Why the generators, alternators, transformers are kVA rated and motors are kilowatt rated? Why shunt generators it is called a self-protected one? How come without the change of commutator, same DC generator can be operated as AC with a reduced performance? What are the applications of a differential compound motor? Why there is no predetermination of efficiency procedure for alternators like transformers and DC machines? Why is transformer a negative feedback circuit? Yes, this is very important one to understand transformer principle. You just check about it. What is the basic difference between circuit and network? Is the power system a series or parallel network or none of it? Is there any change for the current to flow between equal potential points? If so, how? What is the difference between EMF, voltage, potential difference? What is the current is in series? Why current is same in series? Why voltage is same in parallel? For example, here you can apply V equal to IR. Yes, here we have many different things. In I equal to V by R, V is source. In V equal to IR, it is a voltage is a drop. Why the current distribution is a different inside conductor for AC and DC? What is happening physically, not just a skin effect definition? Why the current carrying conductors in the same directions tend to attract? What are the drift, diffusion, conduction and displacement currents? Why can't protons do the real business of electricity? Is there any possibility? Why N-channel semiconductors are most preferred than P-channel? Yeah, these are some very few questions, but there are many more questions. Yeah, you see, you may think these questions are the interview questions or something else, but yes, at the end of the day, if you have better understanding for all these concepts, any technical interview with respect to electrical engineering, I can say you can clear it. Yes, please watch all the answers for all these questions. If you have anything, comment it. I am ready to post answers for those comments.